Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome back to Ninja Guy in Black. Last time we robbed a monk, or more specifically, did a safe breaking routine. And yeah, after a temple style run, we descended to the underground. And well, we're continuing to descend into the underground. While jumping over some very ominous looking claws. What do you think this is going to mean, guys? Surely it doesn't mean that thing will come alive at some point. Whoops. Did I just make a spoiler, or is that foreshadowing? Anyway. Same old with the claw demons. They're really... Well, I'd say these guys are just weak. I mean, you could be playing this for the first time. They're still relatively weak. Four sword swipes, and yeah, that's the end of that. And in this part, well, like I said, I'm going to go as far down as possible. Specifically, you want to go down here. If you wonder why I did not take the expressway down the other way, well, there's a good reason for that. It doesn't end well for you. It ends in something called the game over, I believe. That's usually not a good thing. Ever. It's complicated. It really is, because the game just has that policy where, oh Ryu Hayabusa, you can jump from 125 feet in the air and land, and you will not get hurt. But jump from 135 feet, it's death. What happened in those 10 feet that didn't happen in the other 125? I don't know. Quite frankly, I don't think I ever want to know the answer to that. This is one of the main reasons why you and I will never become ninjas. I don't know if I can speak for your thrill-seeking, but I can tell you one thing. I get scared shitless at about 20 feet, just looking down. That's probably my number one fear is heights. And, well, yeah. Heights is a scary motherfucker. Was it Lake Placid? I went on this scissor lift, went up to about 36 feet in the air. And the only reason I did that was because of a machismo thing. They give you three heights to choose from, and like when the original plan, I was going to go up from about 20 feet. But I'm looking, because they bring multiple buffers, so the people that jump in front of me are into an airbag, are three elderly dudes, and a teenage girl. And I'm a 26-year-old male who's, well, physically able and probably more athletic than all four of them combined. What am I supposed to do? It's like, you know, why don't you just tell me I'm gonna jump 36 feet for Christ's sake? Anyway. It went without a hitch, thankfully. I mean, even if you jump into an airbag, if you land wrong, you can really break something. Like, you could break your knee if you land feet first or whatnot. That's not a good thing. And even when you... And even just falling from that height... It felt like, holy shit. Anyway, the item just got was the Vigorian Flail. Basically, the best way to describe it is the nunchucks, but better. Because you have the same combos with it, it looks more badass, and it also can be leveled up, unlike the nunchucks. Anyway, do you remember these guys at all? Well, these guys... Actually, have we seen these guys yet? I don't know. Anyway, these wasp demons, simple, just flying swallow everywhere and stuff gets done. There's about 15 of them, so that shouldn't be too difficult for you. And they do drop a key, which is nice. So really, the reward is much higher than the danger they really present. There's even a 60 fiend battle with these guys exclusively, and it's a joke. Anyway, as I was saying, jump from... Oh, looks like I'm getting interrupted again. That's fine. Ryu, you might want to kill that thing. You might want to kill it. 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 You aren't going to kill it. Fine. Instead of him killing it, this guy will kill it. Yep, Ninja Gaiden has now crossed into sort of Resident Evil territory with these guys. They are big, they have a lot of hit points, they are extremely slow, and there's two types. There's the melee weapon holders, and then there's the bow guys. Because they're so slow and you have all the speed in the world, you want to take care of the bow guys. Desperately. I mean, because look how drawn out their attacks are. They just like... 3 seconds, wait. Lift up weapon, wait for 3 seconds. Attack. You really shouldn't be guarding, you should be more or less evading, but you can guard, thankfully. But because of this, and because the best way to really kill them quickly is to absorb essence, you want to kill the bow guys, because they'll interrupt your combos very quickly, and they'll knock Ryu on his ass, which isn't nice either. Two notes about these guys. They also have a bite attack. The thing is, you notice that some of these guys don't have their heads on. Well, you can cut their heads off. If you do certain combos, like a flying swallow, or even just a certain charge weapon, you can actually cut their heads off, which will negate the biting attack, but will also make them attack blindly. I don't think they can really hurt each other, but it does give you a slight edge. All the same though, you really just need to really just spam essence attacks. That's probably the best option. But they are not hard, thankfully. In fact, they're actually quite easy. And once you do that, you get the key item in this level, which is the Holy Grail. Yes, Ryu Hayabusa just got the Holy Grail. Somewhere, Arthur and Lancelot and Galahad and Sir Robin the Chicken are going, damn, being a ninja was the answer. Anyway, we're going to be seeing a bunch of these guys throughout this level now. Basically, they're going to dominate this level and part of the next. And, well, needless to say, like I told you, they are not difficult at all. Just because of how slow and deliberate they are, really. I mean, look at this. If they weren't blockable, I would say it's a little tougher, but even so, they're just not difficult. Really, anytime there's a bowman, that's the only time this battle gets remotely difficult. For obvious reasons, I've pretty much said that 5 times now. Other than that, they're so slow and deliberate that you can literally just do what I'm doing right now and, well, have a ton of success while you're doing it. Anyway. even though they say 36 feet, you feel like you're falling so much faster. Wait, did I mention they hit hard? Yeah. I probably should mention that. But you're falling so fast that it doesn't feel like 36 feet. That's one of the weirdest parts about it. Is you don't feel like you're up 36 feet when you're falling. When you look down, oh yeah, absolutely. But as soon as you take the plunge, it goes so fast. It's really, really fleeting. It's a weird phenomenon. Also, I'm not dying to these guys. Give me a break. I said they're not difficult, and by God, they're not difficult. If you get too aggressive, though, you might actually screw yourself over. That's kind of what happened to me there. But yeah, I mean, I love what the one guy did in front of me though in the sizzle. He wanted to, he brought a camera. And, you know, a legit camera. Legit, honest to business camera. Presumably to take pictures of his friends who were also falling off. And the person on the left says, "Sir, you can't dive with that thing on." He's like, "All right. Well, can I throw in the, because she's right. If the person fell with the camera, he could presumably break his ribs because he's wearing around his neck. But if he threw it down on the airbag, well, there's a good chance he falls on that. We can't have that either because, well, once again, you can break something. So he does the next logical thing, which is he threw it to the ground from 36 feet up. And the thing fucking worked still. I am baffled by this. I'm still baffled by it. He did say it was a tough camera, so I will give him some credit. But he threw a camera down to the ground. You can hear the thud and everything from 36 feet up. Just crazy. And it wasn't a cheap camera either. I could tell you that much. Which makes the whole exercise really, really risky. I don't know what I would have done if I was in this position, though, to tell you the truth. I mean, you don't want to throw it down and tell somebody to catch it, because that thing will hurt. But, yeah. Just a little bit of short story there. While I'm busy doing zombie killing. Even though they don't really look like zombies, they're more like fleshy and skeletons or something. There's actually some challenge fights with these guys where they're henchmen and in boss battles, and yes, you want to talk about annoying as fuck? Yeah, annoying as hell. That's basically the way you describe it. Of course, in a vacuum, not too much. I feel like they draw this battle out a little too much, though, to be quite honest. I don't know why the hell that happened. But they definitely drew this battle out. I mean, you saw how tough these guys are. You can take, like, I don't know how many swords. Imagine you were using your nunchucks to do this. You'd probably have to hit them one of them 100 times just to kill them. That wouldn't be fun, would it? Personally, I wouldn't think so. But anyway. Yeah, while that was going on, I completely ignored the fact the elevator was stuck. You kind of have to. Because of those jackasses. But once you take care of the lot, at least you don't have to worry about too much. I mean, even 12 of them, but they do take like an eternity to go down, which isn't fun. But at least now we can escape this area and go back up. So that's a good thing. So the Holy Grail I mentioned was the key item, and really that's what it is. We're supposed to take this back to where the, Guess where? Where the bony claws were. I think you can see where I'm going with this. Kind of like the Book of the Eons, which unlocked the underground. This is going to unlock something too. Or should I say, bring something back to life. But first, we have more of these guys, yeah. Total dicks, I'll tell you that much. Just like, really? Come on. 12 swipes. 12 slashes. 12 whatever the hells. To get rid of them. Fun, I know. It probably is... Well, I'll admit it. If you're playing it, it's a lot... It's one of those games where if you're playing it, it is exponentially more fun than watching it. You know, I'll give you... I will say that for a fact. I mean, some games are like that, and there's others where if you're watching, it's enjoyable, and maybe even more so than playing it, to be honest. You don't think a game like that exists? I'll give you 5 words. I wanna be the guy. There's a game that watching is definitely much more enjoyable than playing. Thankfully, I've never played it. I did see someone play it, though, and yeah, I was losing my shit. Poor Bloody Meow. I don't think he's ever been the same since. But yeah, as I was saying, there are games like that, and this is probably one of them. But going up here, there's going to be 3 zombie guys with bows. You can imagine where this is going to go. Namely to being, this is Sparta. Of course, if I was a better aimer, I'd probably kill these guys a lot quicker. And even so, with only three arrows in hand, there's no way I can actually kill them all. Which really does not work out too well for you. So you have to use other things. And make sure you don't fall off, because now, guess what's going to happen? Or is it going to happen? I think it will. Yep. Because I fell off like an idiot. All three of them fucking came back. And without any arrows, this turns into a really annoying challenge of climbing the damn spiral rock, stone ramp, or whatever you want to call it. I was kind of lucky you didn't knock me off the edge there. But yeah, I mean, it tells you what I think about this area. I had to resort to Nimbo. That alone should tell you what I think. Yeah, I'm using it twice, no less. Now, just don't blow it, will ya? And, well, I'm not gonna blow it. Even if I did blow it, I think they wouldn't come back because, I don't know. I just have a feeling they wouldn't. However, we're done with the lower sanctum for right now. All you gotta do is just climb up a little more and then deposit the Holy Grail into its proper place in the middle of the underground where a curious altar has been set up. I know, right? It doesn't make much sense why there was... I guess it does make a little more sense. But, I don't know, I still can't really get over the fact that Ryu Hayabusa just got the Holy freaking Grail by killing off... and activating it, mind you, by killing off 15 wasp demons. That's the biggest kicker. You can try collecting the Holy Grail during that initial fight, not with the zombies, but with the wasp demons, and it won't let you. It'll say it's not like magically enchanted or something, or it hasn't fed off the blood of the demons or whatever. It's something like that. So remember that next time. Next time you watch Monty Python and the Holy Grail, remember this. It's a trophy that became enchanted due to blood. So anyway, here's the altar. There's the Holy Grail. And there's the boss. This bone dragon here is the boss. And he looks menacing. But he actually is quite easy. One of the easiest boss fights in the game, in my opinion. His primary means of attack will be to do what he's doing right now, which is shooting bone dragon. When that happens, though, get the fuck out of the way, because this bite hurts the most. Now, he also has other things he'll do. As you've probably figured out, the trick here is to take out all his limbs as he places them down. You do want to be careful, though, because when he transitions... Well, you saw the bite, but when he transitions between limb, he might set off an attack. And he might do some sort of stomping or melee or whatever with the claw that he has down. So you want to take that into account. Incidentally, too, essence does not really work, as you're going to find out. See? Now, I don't think this boss fight is particularly hard, as you see. I mean, two limbs down. So he's going to have to go to the back. And geez, he probably won't be biting anytime soon, but he will be doing this tail swipe. If you're playing this, you're not going to really think of taking the tail into account initially. But as you play through it enough, well, yeah. It becomes kind of pressing. Now, they do send out, in the hard mode, they do send out wasp demons to assist this guy, making the fight a little tougher, but really it's not as difficult as you'd think. Which actually is kind of interesting. I mean, yeah, you kind of want to do flying swallows and stuff, but you could also run away from the general area of this guy and just go, say, to the right and down a little bit, where he's not going to attack you. and you can dispatch the wasp demons with relative ease. That area is open to you, but yeah, like I said, you won't be able to attack this one if you were doing that. And well, not a difficult fight at all, just... And the Bone Dragon has ate it. And the sheer force of this has caused cracks in the underground. Because, yeah, the stone wall is probably, what, like 1,500 years old at least? So, yeah, Chapter 6 cleared. A lot of credit on time, so will there be a Master Ninja in the works? You bet. So now, Chapter 7, The Hidden Underground. Does the path to Zarkon truly exist? And yeah, that fight just provided you a reward. Very generous reward when you consider how tough this, this boss fight was. The Lives of the Thousand Gods. Now, do not do... I mentioned this before, but do not, under any circumstances, jump down to the center from where you are now. You will have a game over. Instant game over. Oh, and you go back to your last save point, which means, guess what? You get to redo the boss fight. You probably don't care too much because the boss fight really isn't that tough, but you'd still have to redo it, which blows horribly. Instead, you have to go down here, do this, take out two bats, and then you have the privilege of jumping down to the underground, further underground, where the Bone Dragon's remains are. All in all, kind of simple, but yeah. The game has this allergic reaction to you jumping from 135 feet up in the air, apparently, like I said.